Good evening, everybody. If you would please take your seats, we will begin with our processional hymn, Rejoice, O Pilgrim Throng.
Thank you. Psalm 29. Ascribe to the Lord, O heavenly beings. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength.
Ascribe to the Lord the glory due to his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of holiness.
The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord over many waters. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon.
He makes Lebanon to skip like a calf, and Syria like a young wild ox.
The voice of the Lord flashes forth flames of fire.
The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh.
The voice of the Lord makes the deer give birth, and strips the forest bare, and in his temple all the cry, glory.
The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as king forever.
May the Lord give strength to his people. May the Lord bless his people with peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
We shall walk in peace.
Testament reading is taken from the 6th chapter of Isaiah. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Above him stood the seraphim. Each had 6 wings. With 2 he covered his face, and with 2 he covered his feet, and with 2 he flew. And one called to another and said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." And the foundations of the threshold shook at the voice of him who called, and the house was filled with smoke. And I said, "Woe is me, for I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphim flew to me, having in his hand a burning coal that he had taken with tongs from the altar. And he touched my mouth and said, "Behold, this has touched your lips. Your guilt is taken away, and your sin atoned for." And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send? And who will go for us?" Then I said, "Here am I, send me." This is the word of the Lord. The epistle lesson is taken from the 13th chapter of Hebrews. Keep your life free from love of money, and be content with what you have. For he has said, "I will never leave you nor forsake you." So we can confidently say, "The Lord is my helper. I will not fear. What can man do to me?" Remember your leaders, those who spoke to you the word of God. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. This is the word of the Lord.
Please rise for the Holy Gospel. The Gospel according to St. John, the 3rd chapter. Now there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The man came to Jesus by night and said to him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher come from God. For no one can do these signs that you do unless God was with him." Jesus answered him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." Nicodemus said to him, "How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not marvel that I said to you, you must be born again. The wind blows where it wishes, and you hear its sound, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit." Nicodemus said to him, "How can these things be?" Jesus answered him, "Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Truly, truly, I say to you, we speak of what we know and bear witness of what we have seen, but you do not receive our testimony. If I told you earthly things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except he who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
It was interesting. As soon as I got to the verse that said the wind blows where it will, the wind blew, and I had to look up my verses again. It's an honor to be here with you this evening and to share in what is truly a joyous day for all of you, as it is for my own family. I would begin with this. Congratulations to the class of 2021. It's a tremendous day. This class chose as its theme verse Hebrews 13:8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. And considering what these kids have gone through in the last couple years, I think it's an amazingly perfect verse for them. As I thought about tonight, I remembered my own high school graduation. I remembered the excitement and the anticipation of what was going to come next in our lives. I remember looking at my friends and realizing how much we had come through together over these years and how we had changed over those years of high school. So a lot of things I do remember, but there's a couple things I don't. One of which was, who was the commencement speaker? I have absolutely no idea what he or she said, if they said anything at all. I do remember, though, I was hoping that that speaker would get done quickly so we'd get on with more important things. Now, the high school I attended was in a small city in the state of Mississippi down on the Gulf Coast. It was a very different setting than Fort Wayne. It wasn't a Lutheran high school. There were no Lutheran high schools down there. So I attended a public high school. And back in those days, we were pretty much able to express our faith in the public high school. In fact, we were kind of encouraged to do so and to pray. That same high school, it's no longer true. Those things are not allowed or encouraged or even permitted. Here at Concordia, graduates, your faith has not been marginalized. It has not been silenced. Here you have been surrounded by prayer and the gospel of Jesus Christ, not just occasionally, but every day. That's why all of my children have attended Concordia Lutheran High School. When all is said and done, the most important thing these graduates have learned is this. They were created by God, and they are so loved by Him that He gave His own Son for them. That Son, Jesus Christ, who is indeed the same yesterday, today, and forever. Now, knowing that you're a child of God makes all the difference, no matter where you go in life. Some of the graduates, some of you know exactly what you want to do, and you know exactly how you're going to get there, and that's good. Others of you, well, you're not quite sure yet, so you're still working through that, and that's okay, too. You're young, take some time to figure all that out. Others of you know what you should be doing, but you're doing everything you can to avoid it. If so, you're just like I was. When I got to college, my freshman year, I changed majors not once, four times, until finally I realized I had no choice. I had to become a pastor and prepare for the seminary, and so that's what I did. Now, I tell the graduates this, not because it's about me, but because their future lies before them. And so I'd like to just share a few lessons that I've learned along the way. First, never tell God what you're going to do. He has a much better plan than you ever had. Second, don't tell God how long you're going to do something. And third, don't tell God where you're going to serve Him. He has exactly the right place for you. Many things will change in your lives, graduates. They have in the past. Think about how you began your high school years and then what happened last year and this year. As everything was disrupted, all the plans you had to be adjusted as you, your families, the teachers, the administrators all struggled to find a way to continue on getting this Concordia education in these brand new circumstances where everything had seemed to change, and yet you did it. And you know they're going to continue to change into the future. As they are changing this very night, tonight you'll get your high school diploma. You'll understand before too long what an impact that has in your life. You'll no longer be a high school student. You'll no longer be a student at Concordia Lutheran High School. You'll be an alum and off to something else. That is a big change. I can't see the future for any of them. I don't even know what my own future is. God has not given me that gift. But I do know that God has it all taken care of, and that he will be there with you every day of your life. There's a word, vocation. Yeah, it can mean what you do for a living. That's one way, but it has a much broader meaning. All of us have vocations. You might have a vocation as a son or a daughter. You might have a vocation, graduates, as a brother or sister, as a friend. Someday you might have a vocation as a wife or a husband, or a mother or a father. And those are all sacred vocations. Wherever God has placed you among other people, you are to go and to serve and to love them as you have been loved. You might have, and probably will have, also that vocation in which you earn a living and contribute to the good of others. Some of you might serve in the church as I do. Most of you will not. You'll serve God in some other place in the world. Wherever it is, all service of the Christian ultimately belongs to God who created you and who loves you. So remember who you are, not just your name or whatever your personal characteristics or heritage might be, but who you really are. You are a unique creation of the God of heaven and earth, who is so loved by your Creator that he gave his Son to die for you, that you might live and you might rise always with him. And second, remember who others are. All people share your humanity. They have flaws, they have brokenness, they have gifts and talents, just like you. But they also have that same incredible value that is placed on them by the same God who created and redeemed you. It does not matter what they look like. It does not matter whether they are powerful or powerless. It doesn't matter whether they agree with you or disagree with you. It doesn't even matter whether you find them easy to love or very difficult to love. All that matters is that the Father of Heaven loves them. Speak then and act on behalf of all human beings, just as Jesus did, especially those who are marginalized and live on the outer rims of society. Remember your God-given gifts and use them to the glory of God. That includes the gift of education and the diploma that you will receive this day. And no matter what your vocation is, fulfill it by doing all things in his name. Strive to live with honor and integrity, and never surrender to the darker impulse to sell your soul for fame or riches or power or prestige. In moments of success and joy, give thanks to God who gave you that moment. And when you fail, and believe me, those moments are going to come, give thanks to God for that also. Trust his love to start again and get up. At Concordia, your teachers have prayed with you, but what you may not know is that they have also often prayed for you. And so I would add a few prayers. My prayer for each of you is that in whatever vocation you follow, you will remember the lessons of faith that you have learned at Concordia. Above all things, in your best moments and your worst moments, recall the truth that gives meaning to everything. That truth that God created you, that he loves you, and that he gave his only begotten Son for you. I also pray that you will remember the value of the individual human being, wherever and whoever they might be. None of us are transitory creatures. None of us are simply commodities to be used and discarded. May you treat each person with the dignity and honor that belongs to them as someone loved by God. Pray that you strive for excellence in everything that you do, and that you strive to bring glory to God. Whether the task is small or large, whether it's done in a public view, or whether it's done when nobody is watching, use every gift that God has given to you. I pray that you live a life of integrity and never buy into the popular notion that somehow you can separate your faith and values from what you do. Be authentic, a person who is the same on the outside as on the inside. I pray that you live a life of service. No matter your vocation in the world or the church, care for the needs of others. In your vocation as a husband or wife, a daughter, a son, a father, a mother, a friend, wherever God has placed you, put the needs of others ahead of your own and serve them with the love that God has given to you. And above all, I pray that you will always remember that you are a child of God. Your Savior, who lived, died, and rose again for you, is with you always. In the shifting sands of this world, he is your rock. When all the sand around you is shifting and unstable as the world changes, the rock does not change. And Jesus Christ, that rock, is indeed the same yesterday, today, and forever. I began my reminiscing a bit about my own high school graduation and how I cannot remember who the speaker was and what he or she said. I do remember thinking that the speech had gone on, and I wish that that person would be quiet. So I will try to avoid leaving you with that memory at your own high school graduations. I'll simply add this: may our God richly bless you, your loved ones, and may you always remember that he is with you always, and that he is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Thank you. Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the wonderful gifts that you have given and continue to give to the Concordia Lutheran High School class of 2021. We thank you for their hard work, their perseverance, and for the dedication that they have shown each and every day as they carry out your command to grow in grace and the knowledge of the truth. We thank you for their families, their friends and loved ones who have loved and encouraged them throughout their high school journey, and for the faculty and staff who have helped to teach, mentor, and shepherd them into Christian adults. Father, we pray your blessings on this graduating class. Where they succeed, give them the grace and humility to acknowledge you as the giver of all good things. Where they fall short, give them comfort in the knowledge that your love is sufficient for all that they need in this life. Help them to live lives of Christian virtue, showing the courage to stand up for their beliefs, prudence in their daily lives, the temperance to love and respect their neighbor, and the ability to treat others with justice and fairness. As they leave Concordia Lutheran High School, we ask that you use their talents to glorify you and to serve those around them. Finally, Lord, and most especially, we ask that you keep them all strong and firm in the Christian faith as they prepare to go out into a broken and sinful world. Keep and guard them against the schemes and assaults of the devil, comforting them with the knowledge of your love and forgiveness. All of these things we ask in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please stand for the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. Amen. Please be seated.
Good evening. Concordia Lutheran High School is proud of the many accomplishments of our graduates through the years. As we begin the commencement ceremony for the 86th class to become alumni of Concordia, we want to briefly pause and honor those special alumni who are also with us today. To introduce those alumni is Director of Alumni and Donor Relations, Mr. Greg Rayburn.
Wow, didn't expect that. The Concordia Lutheran High School Alumni Awards recognize and honor outstanding achievements of alumni who have made significant contributions to their community or have been instrumental in serving the high school. In February, the Alumni Awards Committee reviewed nominations for three awards. Last night at the Alumni Awards reception, three individuals were honored. You may read about each honoree in today's commencement program. I will now read a description of each award, and the recipient will be standing as each description is read. The Neil M. Shank Award is named in honor of a 1999 graduate who died in 2007 while serving his country in Iraq. This award honors an alumnus who is 40 years old or younger and has made significant contributions in their given career, community, church, or for Concordia Lutheran High School. Tiffany Grimes from the class of 2001 is this year's recipient. Tiffany's parents are here to represent her, for she is assistant athletic director at the University of Alabama and has to attend to two teams that are contending for a national championship. The next person is the Distinguished Service Award. It is a CLHS graduate who has a record of dedicated support, activity, and service to the ministry of the high school. The Distinguished Service Award goes to Dean Dorfler from the class of 1973. Let's have a round of applause for the two recipients for their awards. The Distinguished Alumnus Award is the highest honor given to a Concordia graduate. It recognizes the alumnus who has demonstrated an ongoing dedication to Christian principles and the church with both lifetime and personal achievement. The 2021 Distinguished Alumnus is Peter Watson from the class of 1979. We now invite Mr. Watson to the podium as he shares a few words with our graduating class. Mr. Watson, let's give him a round of applause.
Dear graduates, families, faculty, and administration, please bow your head as I'd like to begin with prayer. Lord, use my lips and my experiences to speak into the hearts of these graduates, that they may trust in you, Lord, with all their hearts and not lean on their own understanding. In all their ways, acknowledge you, and you will make straight their paths. Amen. Greetings to all. It is really unbelievable that I'm standing here. I was a graduate of a mere 42 years ago. And I don't think sitting out there, of course, it was actually at Zollner Stadium, I would have dreamed that I'd be standing here. I'll tell you a little bit about myself, but before I do that, I want to acknowledge the really incredible year these young students have been through. As we all know, this has been an incredibly challenging year, but I think it's just like our God to look up and say, for these graduates to graduate on an evening like this is a really appropriate ending to their 4 years at Concordia. So I just give praise to God for giving us a beautiful evening like this. So I also want to applaud the students for incredible resilience. I will tell you that as you move forward in your academic journey as well as your career, the resilience you've shown through this year will certainly serve you well. So I want to tell a little bit about my background, and I'm sorry it may make some teachers and some parents cringe a little bit. So I was not a valedictorian or salutatorian, but I certainly applaud those that are going to follow me tonight. I was not on National Honor Society. I was not in the top 10% of my graduating class. I did get voted second most likely to succeed. I don't know why, but I was behind now the Reverend Lutheran Whitfield, who actually received this award 13 years ago. Honestly, I wasn't really all that smart, although I did score top 5% in math on the SAT, and I'm not sure how that happened. Ultimately, then I went on to Rose Holman Institute of Technology. And actually, it was really important because a number of teachers here at Concordia were really instrumental in helping me to go on that journey. I actually remember during my senior year, on my spring break, I went with my parents to visit the two universities I was considering, one of them being Rose Holman. And the admissions officer actually shared with my parents that some are accepted completely on their academic achievement. Others are accepted on gut feel. I knew which one I was. But with all those things I'm not, I want to tell you the one thing I am, and it actually reflects exactly what Reverend Gard said. I'm a child of God who has experienced his full grace and mercy. So I stand here as witness this evening, and I want to tell the graduates, God has God-sized plans for your life, regardless of your academic, athletic, social standing, if you include him in your plans. I have three life lessons I want to share tonight. My first point, seek him in your, or really I should say, his plans. In a book by Justin Camp, Christian author, a book entitled Envision, he stated, our impact, yours and mine, is preordained by our Creator God. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. Ephesians 2:10. I'd like to say I was a perfect practitioner of that advice, but honestly, it wasn't until well into my career that I began to really understand that and acknowledge it. But even given that circumstance, God's hand was still evident throughout my nearly 34 years with Eli Lilly and Company. I had opportunities during that career beyond my wildest imagination. I couldn't have even dreamed, sitting in my maroon gown in 1979, what God had planned for me. I went on to earn two more degrees while I was at the company, company-funded education. I earned my MBA, as well as a master's in public health. I had the opportunity to work at our Puerto Rican manufacturing facilities for 3.5 years. Very fascinating how God works. So I had moved to Puerto Rico and was on the island for all of about 2 or 3 weeks, and I was standing at the grocery store on a Sunday, not yet having found the grocery, or not having found the church, excuse me, that I wanted to attend. And I actually struck up a conversation with some folks in line, and lo and behold, it was the pastor for the only English-speaking Lutheran church on the island. Needless to say, I started attending that church. Actually, that same church became very dear to me and ultimately my wife. I became very involved in the church, not only attending service, but ultimately became church treasurer. And actually, the pastor went on to marry my wife and I on the island of the U.S. Virgin Islands. From there, I went on and actually worked in international regulatory for years. It allowed me to travel to some 20-plus countries over about 3-year period. I believe this international experience actually prepared me for a missions trip the Lord called me to go to post-communist Romania in 1998. That was truly a mountaintop experience. Back at Lilly, God called me into leadership, working across 4 different functions of the company. Ultimately, it culminated in my last 7 years in executive leadership. Looking back, the opportunities were part of God's plan for my life. Even if I wasn't always seeking him, he was always faithful to me. You've probably heard this before, but Mark Twain once said, "The 2 most important days of your life, the day you were born and the day you find out why you were born." In 2018, I heard Dr. Jim Lohr speak, and he offered a 3rd day, the day you fully align your life and energy with that why. The why God has planned for your life, if and only if you will seek him. Christian author John Eldridge offers this wisdom. There is no formula. You go into the wilderness with God, ask, what do I mean to you? Who am I to you? Tell me what you think of me. It's just that simple. when we engage God in this way, however we do it, he's sure to answer at some point in some way, probably in one you won't expect. My career journey was not what I expected. Again, God had bigger plans for me than I ever imagined. Even now in retirement, God is leading me into areas I did not foresee, be it mentoring young professionals through a program called Edge Mentoring, be it in generous giving to ministries with the treasures God has blessed me with, or finally, be it in serving, for example, working with a coalition of community activists and faith-based organizations to identify ways of reducing gun violence and homicides in Indianapolis, as well as serving on the board of a program called Elevate Indy, working in the IPS, Indianapolis Public School, high schools and feeder schools, to teach leadership and character training for select students. This isn't how I envisioned retirement, but it's been far more fulfilling than I ever dreamed. God works that way. To that end, I have a favorite saying that is attributed, although somewhat disputed, to Winston Churchill, the famed Prime Minister of the United Kingdom during World War II. We make a living by what we get. We make a life by what we give. Graduates, the second point I'd like to make is beware of false teachers, particularly as many of you prepare to go off to university and honestly, even in the workplace. Some professors, often those with lots of letters behind their names from some of our most prestigious institutions, can be the most agnostic or atheistic individuals you'll encounter. I listened to a podcast from Ravi Zacharias not too long ago, and he actually told the story of a young graduate that joined his ministry. And I think it's a very telling tale. She wanted to know Mr. Zacharias to know that she had actually caused a little bit of a trouble in her university because she had a professor who berated God and believers routinely in her class. She finally worked up the nerve to approach the professor. The professor wasn't very pleased. So he sent her to the dean of students. The dean of students apparently proceeded to do the wag of the finger in her face and say, young lady, you've been indoctrinated into your Christian belief system by your parents. We are seeking to help you think critically and free you from that indoctrination. That's a really daunting thought to me. And I think it's really a tale to really forewarn you of what you may encounter as you go forward. Personally, I've worked along some of the best and brightest research scientists at Eli Lilly and Company. Some were strong believers, but many were agnostics. Simply because of their scientific training, they could not allow themselves to believe in a loving and merciful God. Simply the null hypothesis, God doesn't exist, can't see him, can't scientifically prove he exists, and therefore accept the null hypothesis. God's word provides great insight on this issue. Therefore, as you received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in him, rooted and built up in him, and established in the faith, just as you were taught, abounding in thanksgiving. See to it that no one takes you captive by philosophy and empty deceit, according to human tradition, according to the elemental spirits of the work, and not according to Christ. Colossians 2, 6 through 8. My third and final point, remember who you are and whose you are. You have the title of beloved. It's not defined by the alphabet behind your name, nor worldly titles. I've actually had a few of them. Trust me, it's not what matters. Here's what God has to say about who you are. Genesis 1:27, you were created in his image. 1 John 4:4, you belong to God. 1 Peter 2:9, you are chosen, God's special possession. Ephesians 2:10, you are a masterpiece. Galatians 3:26, you're his child. It seems safe to say that you're kind of a big deal to God. But be prepared, the journey ahead is not always easy. Matter of fact, it's often really hard. Scripture reminds us, the Lord said, I've said these things to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart, I have overcome the world. For me, life's challenges have included divorce, remarriage, 4 adopted children, marital struggles, wayward teens, death, in-laws, brother, eventually dad and mom, which many of us know nothing prepares us for that, cousin murdered, another overdosed, family mental health issues, faith doubts, cancer, just to name a few. And I'm guessing more to come. But none of this steals away the hope we have in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The stuff I just read off isn't the stuff we put on a resume, but honestly, these experiences have really refined my character and strengthened my abiding faith. My former pastor, Glenn MacDonald, offered this insight in a recent devotion. Our culture exalts gifts, athletic prowess, artistic creativity, leadership savvy, physical beauty, and intellectual brilliance. Giftedness appears to be the royal path to the good life. If you have the right gifts and work like crazy to develop them, you can become rich, powerful, and popular. Character, on the other hand, is how we describe the landscape of our souls. Character development takes time. It's mostly a hidden reality that doesn't translate into bullet points on a resume. Experience reveals that if we don't have the character to support our gifts will inevitably become destructive both to us and to others. Once again, Scripture supports this ideal. We rejoice in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance. Endurance produces character. Character produces hope. And hope does not put us to shame. Because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. Romans 5:3-5. Finally, my own senior pastor, Aaron Brockett, last Sunday, in a sermon on pride, said, prideful pretending causes me to be more concerned about managing my image than developing my character. Again, Scripture provides great insights to this point. Put on then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, compassionate hearts, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience, bearing with one another, and if one has a complaint against another, forgiving each other, and by the way, not dissing each other on social media, as the Lord has forgiven you, so you must also forgive. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony, and let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. In closing, I want to reiterate my 3 points. Seek him in your plans. Beware of false teachers and teaching. And remember your title of beloved. God has God-sized plans for your life, and I wish you Godspeed on your journey ahead. Thank you, a Christ follower and proud Concordia alum I am. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Watson. Members of the Board of Directors, faculty, pastors, and honored guests, parents, friends, relatives, and especially to the class of 2021, good evening. We are here with an opportunity to worship and give glory to our Lord as we celebrate the commencement of the 86th group of seniors in Concordia's history. The word commencement means a beginning, a start. It is not the end. This baccalaureate commencement service represents the best of Concordia's tradition and its mission to pursue Christ-centered educational excellence. It is the concluding event to an academic year, a time to recognize the power of the gospel active and alive at Concordia, a celebration of Christian education. In your worship, your prayers, and in your conversations today, I encourage each of you to join with the faculty and board of directors in thanking God for the gift of youth and the many academic and individual accomplishments of this special group of Concordia students. We ask that you extend your cooperation as we move through today's ceremonies. It is our prayer that this day will be an occasion that will be remembered with pride and joy by all of us assembled here. And now it is my honor to introduce the salutatorian of the class of 2021. Miss Shelby Schlicker, daughter of Tavis and Jennifer Schlicker, plans to attend Mississippi State University to study mathematics and computer science. Shelby attends Holy Cross Lutheran Church and is a graduate from Holy Cross Lutheran School. She has been involved in a cappella choir, chamber choir, a member of the Pro-Life Club, National Honor Society, on the homecoming court, the student body president, a koinonia leader, and participated in soccer, tennis, basketball, and rowing during her time at CLHS. Here's what Shelby says she loves about Concordia. I love the incredible amount of rich and full opportunities that are offered at Concordia to participate and excel alongside other extremely talented students and caring staff. Please welcome and congratulate Concordia salutatorian, Miss Shelby Schlicker.
Welcome, everyone. It is my distinct pleasure to thank all those who have been monumental in the success of the class of 2021, especially our parents, guardians, friends, and relatives who have provided for us, supported us, nurtured us, and modeled God's unconditional love in our homes and in our lives. We have also had 18 years of various teachers, staff, coaches, pastors, and mentors who have pushed us to grow and encouraged us to strive towards our potential, sometimes even painfully so. For example, my fifth grade teacher adamantly insisted that I could never escape public speaking, and here we are. But as we finally say our goodbyes to the people and memories of Concordia and look to the future, I think one aspect is abundantly clear. Nothing is clear. The thing is, I don't know what the future may hold. You don't know, our valedictorian doesn't even know. No one really knows, honestly. That is what makes life so exciting. It is ultimately unpredictable. I don't know what's going to happen in my life, and I don't know what's going to happen in any of the rest of your lives. I've spent so much of my life trying to plan something that is unplannable. I didn't plan on moving to Fort Wayne, Indiana. I didn't plan on becoming salutatorian, and I certainly didn't plan on my junior and senior years of high school being dramatically changed by the coronavirus. But if there's only one positive that came out of my last 2 years at Concordia, it is that I finally learned that I don't have to be in control. In fact, none of us can. Control is an illusion. No matter how hard we strive for it, we can never achieve it. And whether you like it or not, that's okay. We aren't meant to be in control. If we were, life would be too predictable. There is someone greater than us who is in control. He is the person who truly knows. He knows the big picture and what is absolutely in our best interest. Our greatest fault is ignoring his impact on our lives and creating a false image of ourselves in control. Life can never truly be lived in the way it was meant to be until we face the truth of God's intentions for us. So be adaptable to God's will. He has the ultimate control of our lives, and we can trust him with it. I don't know what's going to happen to us in the next couple weeks, months, or even years, but I do know that we can handle whatever God throws at us. As Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11 says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." We don't know what the future holds, but we do know who holds the future. God knows each and every tomorrow. Basically, we're tasked with holding tight to him and enjoying the ride. So, class of 2021, strap on your seatbelts and enjoy the ride.
Miss Megan Miller is the daughter of Mike and Christy Miller. Megan plans to attend Hope College to study biomedical engineering. She attends Christ Hope Ministry and Church and is a graduate from Holy Cross Lutheran School. Megan has been involved in Concordia's a cappella choir, Honors Academy, National Honor Society, is a Koinonia leader and peer tutorer during her time at our school. When asked about Concordia and her time at the school, Megan loves. Concordia allows students to be involved in things that they are passionate about while teaching them how to use their gifts for God's glory. Please welcome Concordia's 2021 valedictorian, Miss Megan Miller.
On behalf of the class of 2021, I would like to start by thanking God, through whose grace we are here tonight. I would also like to express appreciation to our families, friends, teachers, coaches, and administrators for the support you have given us these 4 years. Your dedication and commitment was indispensable in our educational journey. In a particularly trying year, filled with many unique challenges, you remind us that we always have someone in our corner for whom we can be grateful. I will also want to thank my parents for all the help they have given me throughout my life. Their support has been instrumental, and I am truly blessed. Now to the graduates. As you should be aware by this point in the service, our senior class verse this year was Hebrews 13:8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Jesus Christ was the same in August 2006 on the first day of kindergarten. It is a day that I personally remember because the kid who sat across from me kept hitting the table and making my blocks fall. In kindergarten, when adults invariably asked us what we wanted to be when we grew up, we gave an outlandish answer, such as a princess, astronaut, or superhero. Over the years, we outgrew this and set more reasonable goals for ourselves. Except Isaiah, who still wants to be an astronaut. But in all seriousness, while our initial goals were unlikely, they were not bad goals because they helped us determine what we want in life. The future superhero wanted to serve the community. The astronaut desired to see the world through a different lens. And the princess had an aspiration to be an intermediary between countries. We were the future social workers, entrepreneurs, and diplomats. Before we knew it, we were starting our freshman year with new goals. Mainly to survive the first day and make new friends. We were divided into groups based on the animal on our name tag. I was a koala, in case anyone was interested, and we were forced to talk to new people. Soon, former strangers were our new best friends, and we realized that high school wasn't so scary after all. With this goal achieved, we set our sights on greater and higher achievements. The athletic teams aimed to go to state, a feat that was accomplished by the boys and girls cross-country teams, as well as multiple swimmers and track athletes this year. The music programs aspired to do well in competition. This desire was fulfilled in multiple music ensembles attending and placing in state competition. Or maybe you had more individual goals, such as earning good grades or getting into a specific college. In any case, the goals we set for ourselves over the last 4 years have driven us to do our best to succeed. But we did not achieve these things solely for ourselves. Rather, we did these things to bring glory to God and to point others to Him. While Soli Deo Gloria, glory to God alone, is the motto of the music department, I believe it applies to the entire Concordia community, no matter what activities we participated in. Now, 4 years later, we are graduating from high school, and Jesus Christ is still the same as we are facing the thousands of goals in our future. And this time, the goals feel a little more real, a little more scary. While I do not feel qualified to offer advice for the monumental task ahead, I would like to offer some encouragement. We are still the future social workers, entrepreneurs, diplomats, or whatever else we choose to be. The goals we have set for ourselves throughout our lives have led us to this point and will continue to motivate us for the rest of our lives. And in all things, in all goals, in all situations, remember, we are not alone. While we cannot reach our goals on our own, God is faithful and will guide our paths. After all, Jesus Christ will be the same forever. So, as we leave Concordia, even if we forget everything else we have learned here, we must always remember this one thing. God always has our hand, so let's go where He leads.
Before we begin the formal awarding of diplomas, I'd like to take a minute and just say a huge thank you to our faculty and our staff at Concordia Lutheran High School. The last 15 months have not been easy. A tremendous amount of adjustments, moving on the fly, making plans and having to rearrange those plans for either in-person or remote learning. Could I please ask all of our faculty and our staff who are in attendance tonight to please stand? And would you please join me and take a little bit of a stretch break, stand and give them a round of applause, please. Thank you. I'd also like to make special recognition of two very important people in our school and our school community for a number of years. Our head of school, Michael Tom, who's been out here and will be out here again in a couple of minutes, has accepted a call to go up to Concordia University in St. Paul, Minnesota. And our assistant head of school, Mr. Joshua Sommermeyer, is also moving on after this school year. Mr. Tom, would you please step to the top of the dugout? Would you please help me and join? Round of applause, just a simple thanks. Thank you. God's blessings to both of you. Concordia Lutheran High School annually awards an academic scholarship to three incoming freshmen. These Concordia scholars have demonstrated excellence and service in significant ways to our school during their high school years. I invite our three Concordia scholars to rise and please be recognized. The Honors Academy of Concordia Lutheran High School recognizes students who have met a rigorous academic program, research, leadership, and a mentor-directed community service activity during their studies at Concordia. I invite our five Honors Academy students to rise and please be recognized. The National Honor Society recognizes character, leadership, and service of students who qualify academically. Student members are voted into this Honor Society by the faculty. I invite the 41 seniors who have earned membership into Concordia's chapter of the National Honor Society to please rise and be recognized. And finally, Concordia Lutheran High School awards an academic honors diploma to seniors who have successfully completed a prescribed academic program that's set forth by the state of Indiana and our own school board. This achievement results from students' hard work, desire, and commitment in applying God's gift in their academic coursework. I ask that the 82 students who will receive an academic honors diploma tonight to rise and be recognized. Mr. Gutman, member of the boards of directors, Mr. Tom, our head of school. The graduating members of the class of 2021 are presented to the board of directors of Concordia Lutheran High School. These individuals have successfully completed all academic requirements for graduation as set forth by our school board, the Concordia Education Association, and the Indiana Department of Education. The faculty joins me in saluting these students for their achievement. I recommend these students for their diploma. I invite Mr. Tom, our head of school, Mr. Gutman, our chairman of the school board, and Mr. Rayburn, director of alumni and donor relations, to please join me here at home plate.
Megan Diane Miller. Shelby Suanna Schlicker. Morgan Ruth Aldrich. Cameron Thomas Allen. Peter Bennett Allison. Caitlin Marie Amstutz. Ross David Augenstein. Samuel Robert Amick. Brittany Claudeth Baldwin. Meg Carrie Barkley. Braden Roman Bartquick. Jonathan Steele Bates. Mallory Elizabeth Bainey. Luke Shopper Bentz. Lindsay Leanne Burning. Noah David Bieberick. James Kiro Benz. Alexander Gabriel Briggs. Finley Devin Brooks. Dalton Lee Brown. Madison Paige Brown. Catherine Elizabeth Bryan. Brenna Elise McCormick Butler. Thomas Esteban Cardenas. Andrew Carl Carr. Jace Darrell Connor. Benjamin Wesley Carell. Lauren Madeline Butler. David Costantini. James Philip Cotter. Evan Gabriel Cox. Shantice Unasia Craig. Chastity Unlander Craig. Madeline Marie Dahlgren. Brandon Lamar Davis. Hannah Lila Marie Dufresne. Amir DeMille Drew. Courtney Ann Marie Duff. Anna Elise Dooley. Matthew Paul Dooley. Madison Alexa Durnell. Bladen Riley Esslinger. Leah K. Fairfield. Jacob Gustav Felton. Aaron Leilani Flanagan. Mackenzie Lee Mary Ford. Karen Lee Frerking. Riley Caroline Fulton. Michaela Renee Gaines. Caleb Matthew Daniel Gard. Isaiah David Gernhardt. Max Hamilton Gleave. Matthew Christian Gegline. Caleb Victor Goodwin. Bethany Claire Gottschalk. Tyler Gordon Grossman. David Joseph Gutman. Michaela Ann Haggerty. Brandon Charles Hamilton. Cooper Jones Harris. Carissa Marie Hatton. Grace Noel Headkey. Allison Paige Hagerfeld. Isabella Marie Henry. Joshua Carlton Henshin. Taylor Diane Hepburn. Mallory Rose Hockemeyer. Nigel Thomas Holm. Braden Chase Holy. Callie Joe Hoover. Kwamein Latrell Hoover. Samuel Robert Hudson. Cole Avery Humbert. Garrett Andrew Inniger. Peyton Andrea Jackson. Sarah Geronimo. Graham David Johnson. Holly Lee Johnson. Cameron Michael Johnson. Landon James Jones. Owen Robert Kaiser. Rhea Elizabeth Kaczynski. Carissa Grace Canablo. Andrew Thomas Koenig. Thomas Andrew Koenig. Thomas Kevin Kratzman. Lauren Elaine Crin. Isabel Amanda Lehman. Chandler Kent Lindsay. Elliot Philip Lochner. Jenna Paige Lusk. William Jackson Maple. Isaac David Marks. Kylie Maya Marks. Abigail Joy Mays. Miranda Lee McBride. Timothy O'Neill McDonough. Annalise Christine McGee. Jackson Mitchell McKinney. Allison Rose McQueen. Kyle Jeffrey Measley. Atalia Naomi Mendez. Christian Michael Joseph Messman. Lydia Hope Moser. Daniel Ben Muller. Jaden Robert Musilli. Logan Benjamin Narwald Settle. Caitlin Grace Nix. Prisca Cecilia Norwood. Amarion Chad Oates. Logan David Poppy. Nicole Lynn Poppy. Braden Stevenson Payne. Nathan James Pennekamp. Desire Marie Purnell. Ella Joyce Piper. Thalia Isabella Pierce. Alexis Nicole Rios. Paige Elizabeth Rogers. Austin Benjamin Rohde. Reagan Renee Rubrake. Hannah Elizabeth Rupert. Isaiah Michael Rusher. Matthew Edward Scholes. Dane Matthew Schaefer. Scarlett Ann Gray Schaefer. Xavier Marshall Sheehan. Monica Noelle Sheets. Gavin William Shirk. Kara Elise Simon. Jonah Timothy Smith. Colson James Smithson. Logan Andrew Snyder. Ryan Michael Snyder. Luke Newhouse Speckhard. Lauren Kate Spires. Brielle Renee Steele. Jaden Elizabeth Stevens. Tyler William Strothman. Connor Lee Stuff. Savannah Marie Swadner. Jordan Lene Sweet. Eduarda Tartarella Nascimento. Madeline Elaine Tom. Marcy Pio Trish. George Hickson Turney. Kylie Sue Turnpaw. Brock Dean Tweedy. Hunter Patrick Valentine. Jackson Clark Valentine. Catherine Ruth Van Sweden. Cameron David Vanderbosch. Scott Lyle Van Landingham. Sebastian Villalobos. Kaylin Alyssa Volker. Ariana Renee Voles. Caleb Daniel Walls. Joshua Matthew Walls. Jager Luke Wedevin. Caden Quinn Whitaker. Maya Michelle Williams. Alexandria Heaven Winkle. Gretchen Corrine Whitmer. John Farron Woods III. Jordan Alexander Wright. Bennett Domenico Yamanaka. Ethan Michael Yoder.
The graduates, please find your seats while I invite Ms. Alexis Rios, president of the class of 2021, to please come forward for the tassel ceremony.
Would the class of 2021 please stand? In light of the spiritual challenge laid before our class, as a symbol of our commencement and commitment to the Christian ideals and tradition of Concordia Lutheran High School, I invite the members of the class to move their commencement tassels from right to left.
Now, if you could have a seat for just a couple more minutes. At this point in the ceremony, it's my honor to give a final charge to the graduates. This is a time for one final word. Maybe just a few more words of advice, that thing that maybe we've been holding back till right at the end. And so as I think each year about what to say to the graduating class, those final words of inspiration and encouragement, and I think, what haven't we shared yet? What's one more thing that we can impress upon you before you go? And the truth of the matter is, there's nothing. You see, each and every day we have given our best to you. It's been in the day in and day out inner workings of Concordia Lutheran High School, our relationship with you day in and day out, where we have given you what we have. We haven't saved anything to the end. Each day the faculty and staff has enjoyed walking alongside you and serving you the very best we can, and now we stand very proudly congratulating you on this accomplishment. We do ask that you come back every now and again and share how God has impacted your lives with us. You see, that's one of the true blessings that we get to have in education, is we get to see the journey that you're on and how God impacts you and uses you down the road. And so we save nothing, but only give you more encouragement, bless you on your way. Thank God for the opportunity to have known you and to have spent a portion of your life with us and to see how God has used you. Thank you so much, graduates, for the way in which you have poured yourselves into Concordia Lutheran High School, for the talents and abilities that you've shared, not only with us, but with the community. God's blessings to you as you go, and go get them. Now we join together in the final hymn, Lift High the Cross. On behalf of the Board of Directors, we have one final celebration tonight, a fireworks display in honor of the 2021 graduates. Helping us count down to the start of the fireworks, a group of seniors here, and they will count down from 21.